everyone, and welcome back to an episode of Jurassic World Alive. We've changed the camera, as you might see, the angle's different. You may even see my iPad, I apologize for that. We are taking on Morton Rex with another Morton Rex. My Morton Rex. We've got two fellow Alliance members, I think, here. We've got Zeke Dad and Death Rocker. Union Rex said, I think he had work or something like that, but this is gonna be an interesting tactic. So what I'm gonna do, I need a crit to kill. Ooh, okay, but I have to do this. Right, so we have Turbo Moloch for the heal, which I don't know if it'll be enough. I think we need a Tornado. I feel like we need a Tornado, but hey-ho, we'll see how it goes. We're also getting an attack increase from this. Oh, this is gonna be so good. This is gonna be so good. So I have just had like a quick switch around. Oh no, we didn't kill it. Did I even get a crit? I don't even think, oh wait, hold on. I think I might be dead. I think I might be dead. Unless a Turbo Moloch goes for a priority heal on me, I think I'm dead. Like, what's the damage from coming out from that Mortem? It's like 3,000, right? It's 3,000. Yeah, I think maybe I need more health. Oh, and it's a crit. Yeah, I'm definitely dead. I'm gone. Yes. Yeah. just get it over with. Surrender, it's fine. Because you want to see all the weird little tactics that you can possibly come up with. I'll do another retry. Maybe not Mortem. We didn't get the crit. We got like the 20%. That was annoying. So hopefully this time, I mean, there's going to be no difference. Really. The Brontotherium's not a bad choice though. Yes, sorry, I was talking about, yes, setup's changed. We're going to be live streaming something that should be quite interesting. And I've made sure that everything's okay, so I tidied my desk a little bit. Also, you guys probably haven't even realized. How dare you? But I've been ill for the past, like, almost, well, not a week, but definitely 4 or 5 days. Today's the first day that I feel kind of okay. So, come on, crit. Please crit. Okay, here's the difference. Okay, so, right. Hopefully. Oh, he's gonna hit everybody with that shield. Does Majungasaurus hit everybody? Or is it just... Please don't hit everybody. Just give everyone a shield. I'm still dead, yeah? Damn it! It was 3,000 as well. I was gonna die no matter what. Oh, that's interesting. Okay, well, it was worth a shot. It was worth a shot, right? You gotta try it. So, you need something with a lot of health. Well, I could back out and then put some health boosts on Mortem. That's something I don't know if I want to really do. I don't think they're worth really putting speed boosts, so health boosts might be more beneficial. Come on, I want to see what my crit chance is once, because it's, we get the speed up from the Turbo Moloch, we get the attack increase, and the crit chance up from Tristonics, right? 50% chance, the critical chance increases by 30%. So 50, 60, 70% chance. 70% chance every time there. Didn't get it. Okay, so here it comes. Okay, I just want to double check. What is my crit chance here? 70%! Come on! Yes! Oh my god! Finally, that bloody happens! Twice though! Okay, so I haven't been hit by anything. The only problem with this strategy now is that he's probably gonna get a crit. He does get a crit, which is like 3,000 damage, which is gonna hurt everybody. And then he does a big hit onto somebody. So I don't think anybody has distraction. I don't. I can tell you that for a fact. I don't have distraction. I don't think Turbo Moloch has distraction. I'm pretty sure Tristonix doesn't either. He's going for a big hit on something. I may as well just go for a massive hit and see what I can do. Mortem v Mortem. How is this gonna go? Not very well. Oh, it's got. I mean, somebody's gonna die here. Somebody's gonna die. I would have. Yeah. I mean, I guess. Yeah. Well, I mean, what's the, Is it going for the highest health? Which is probably the Tristonics, which is not good at all. And there you go, there's 9,000 damage. Oh, if only it was a crit. If only it was a crit. And then here comes this. Oh, bam! Almost 8,000 damage. And yeah, Tristonics is definitely out. Oh, tell you what though. Level 30 might have been able to hang on, especially with some health boosts. So now he's just going to hit a random dude. He's going to hit a rando. I'm so dead. Somebody's going to get a hit here at full force, which is, I don't even know what that is. What, like 4,000 damage, 5,000 damage? So pretty much we're going to lose another one at the end of this turn. I'm just wondering what would work with a Mortem. Ah! Oh! Then I get the crit. Okay, then woo! Level two with a Mortem V. Oh, he's going for me. Oh, thank you. Bye. Bye, Cruel. But we got a round two. Well played. Well played. I think the best thing we need to do is just Erlikosaurus. Erlikosaurus or Phosphoraka. I think we can do that again. Well played. I don't know. Antonia's still coming back for more. What a champion. Normally you come into these videos and it's all ready to go. But this you've seen. You've seen the brain in action. Big brain ideas. Losing over and over again. Okay, so this time we should be okay. So I'm going to target Mortem. So that means that his attack goes down and there's no critical chance. So therefore, he's only going to do 2,000 odd damage. And then it's up to whether Turamolik wants to heal or whether I want to heal. He doesn't even need a crit. I don't even think he needs a crit. I mean, as long as that Brontotherium is faster than the minions, yeah. And even I'm faster. Oh, I remember. Remember, I've got so many boosts and I have not used it. So what we're looking for in this incubator is 35. That's a big ask. I'd say 15 is a good ask. You probably get that. 35 is a very good ask. If we get a very big ask, if we get 35, it means that we have a level 27 Mortem. 27! Some people have already got 27 Mortem. So there we go. So we just need a, they need me again here, I think. So I think the Turamolik has to go for it because he's going to do a big hit here. So Turamolik heals. You need to do, he needs to do the lesser heal because if I do it, we got a big hit here coming through onto somebody. So we got the minor heal, which is probably going to give everyone back to full health. Then he's not getting a crit with this. And he's doing, is it 4,000 damage? I think it might be 4,000 damage to somebody or whoever's got the highest health, which is great because it's not going to be me. It's probably going to be the, Okay. Just could have went for a huge attack there. Did Zigdad drop out? Oh, that's not good. Could have done twice as much as that. Okay, so there we go. That should give us all the full health. 6,000, yes, he's definitely going to go for it. So I needed to do this. I needed to drop that distraction and the critical chance. It's not the fastest. I'll give you that. It's definitely not the fastest. Probably going to do it in another two. Oh, he did taunting anyway. Okay, yeah, he was going to take that hit. But there's no crit chance. Okay, so now somebody needs to come through, and probably the Turamolik, with the priority heal, which he's going for. I don't think any of us are gonna kill him. So, I don't think we're gonna kill him here. We're not gonna do that much damage. I don't think so. Sorry, did the light go? Computer, wake up. Right, how much damage we're gonna get done? 5,000, and then my hit. Now, because Turamolik has kind of used up all its healies, it means that I have to heal next. So that's it. So 9,000 health, is that? Or is that including in his total? So he did heal, but didn't get a crit. Okay, so I can go for my priority heal onto him. There's no point doing it to anybody else. Unfortunately, however, it does mean that there could be a chance of 4,000 flipping damage coming through, which means that Turmoilok next turn is going to have to go for a lesser heal. But that's okay. That's okay. I'm not expecting him to die this turn. I'm expecting him to die next turn. So this one, it's all right. It's not the most amazing. You see that? There you go. He would have been dead there. Oh, he didn't get the crit either. Oh, nice. Okay, so lesser heal's going to come through. Then he's going to do a big heal. A big hit onto somebody here. If Zigdat hadn't have disconnected there, we would be starting the next round, which actually would have been bad because we would have all been on low health. So it's better that we're starting this way. However, somebody's taking a big hit here. Oh, it's not looking good. That's not an invincibility. I think somebody might be dead. It's going for the highest health, so I don't think they are. I think we're good, yes, because it's going to be him. And he's deliberately done it. He's deliberately went for a taunting. I don't think he needed to do that. Oh, this is, there's no crit, but no! Oh, damn it. That's it, we've lost. Oh, well, we did just as good just doing a regular move. Damn it. Nah, there's no chance. And now we skip forward to when we actually do it. Yay! Ooh, we got back here, but he's about to do a big hit. We're cleansing himself. So there's nothing really we could do here. Lowest is 4,600. He doesn't get a crit, so we have survived. What's the next one? Is the next one like one big hit? Oh, man. I think the heal coming from the Turmoilok is going to save us, but it's not a cleanse, right? It's just a big hit. Okay, just a big hit. Okay, I can do that. I think the Turmoilok needs to heal. With me reducing it and with Turmoilok healing, I think we've got it. So we basically repeated everything except for this time Zigdad went for that, the big hit. And it made all the difference. So with 3,000, it does 6,000 normally, and then I reduce it. So we're looking at maybe 4,000? 4,000, I think. Oh, I don't know. He might kill this dude. Oh, is he gonna go? He's not gonna get a crit, but is it enough? It might be enough. Oh, he's at 501. 101. Oh my god. Okay. Priority heal's coming through. I think we're good. We're good. He's gonna be healed as long as I reduce this because it's not a cleanse. So the emergence healed. How much does that heal? Whoa, that's enough. He's safe, no matter what. And it goes for the lowest, so it would have targeted him. Oh, I think we're gonna do it. What is this strat? With an unboosted dealer Jared. Oh, getting the crit. And then comes in for, yeah. Is that Brontotherium? What is this thing? I can't remember what it's called. Yeah, I think Brontolasmosaur or something like that. There it is. Okay, so this is it. One final go. Everybody just going for the biggest hit that they can. And I think that's killed him. Because now he's going to hit everybody. And even if we don't kill him here, one of us is going to survive. So that's already taken down. And then this big hit coming in. How much damage is that? Oh, I think the Brontotherium does 1,800 base. So doubling that, that's 3,600. So whatever I do here is just going to add on top of that. So yeah, he has to do 1,200. Oh, there we go. Oh, we finally did it after how many battles? Well done, guys. Well done. Hold on, we need a... Well done. Well, you did good. Took us a while, but we did that. Wow. No communication whatsoever there. We just knew that second time, Zigdad just had to go for that. So we may be able to get level 27 Mortem Rex here. If not, I still want to add some health boosts. I think that's the best thing to do. Boost Mortem Rex by one health to help with the Hadrosaur Lux raid, and the rest just goes into health. I'm thinking, because I've already maxed its attack. So we need 35. Oh, Raptor Jesus Beast, please. Come on, 35. It's good. Like, maybe a 50. I've never seen a 35. 10, yes. A 15, yes. A 20, maybe. A 25's a tall ask. 30, definitely. 35. So let's see. What we get? What we get? We got a 20. Oh, God. I don't know what made that. It flew out the speakers. That 15 away. I would say next week, we are going to have a level 27 Mortem Rex. So, again, this is my team at the moment. I have, like, loads of boosts if I organize. Yeah, organize, go speed. I have, where is it, 100? Is it 100 per boost? I think it is. So I've got 24 speed boosts, attack boosts, 47 health boosts, and 36 speed boosts still to use. And really, I've only used like a little bit on Magnetator because I did face somebody who had, I don't know, just having 150 speed made the difference there. Attack wise, 3000 on that Mortem Rex. Everything else is the Draco and the Phosphora, even though they haven't been the most. I mean, Draco Rex more so than Phosphora, but I think that's because Phosphora, you need to boost that attack. You need to make it dangerous. So we could even just give it 20 attack boost straight away so that its attack goes from, I don't know, what's its attack? I think it's 1,600 at the moment. 1,400. Ah, let's give it a boost. But you need those attack, you need that attack because that, once it comes in and it's gonna do that instant attack, double. So it would do 2,800 at the moment, but we could boost it to, I don't know, what's the, at the max? We could give it an extra 50%. So at the moment, if it stayed at level 26, it would get another 700 attack, meaning it would be 2,100 base, plus, you know, it's instant rampage, so it would do 4,200 damage in one hit, straight off the bat. I mean, if you got armor or any other kind of things, then yeah, whatever. But that's dangerous. I am actually trying to, I don't go on here. We'll put it back to default. I'm trying to level up my Tornado Rex. I think it is. My Tornado Rex. Yeah, here it is. Here it is. However, I just don't have the coin. I've just got 250,000 at the moment. And as you can see, I've got 16,000 Tornado Rex. Just seeing the health in this thing and the attack at level 23, mind you, it's like, and the fact that as long as things can be sped reduced, you just go for a resilient strike right off the bat. So already, Earl Indominus doesn't get off its cloak and it gets its speed reduced, so it's a counter for that. Most things are like an Indoraptor, which aren't really a problem anymore. And just with the 20% crit chance, that's really, really good. Like four times average, which is 5%. And that's with no boosts on it at all. So you could really boost this attack, making it super deadly. And I had this thought occur to me not too long ago. I thought, what if I just had my whole team like Mortem Rex? So every one of them is just a huge tank that can just, well, not, you know, not really like a glass cannon, but has a load of attack. So it doesn't even matter, you know, this beats that, this beats that. It's just all one. So you're never going to face an opponent that does all one. You know, all attack or all speed or whatever. I'm thinking maybe that's an interesting strategy to go down. Just Tornado Rex, Mortem Rex, Phosphora. Just have these dinosaurs or creatures that have super high attack. And so you just keep wailing at your opponent. And they might have an Onanus Maxima. And they might have, you know, the Turtle Hybrid or whatever it is, the Rhino. But once that's gone, there's really not much that they can do, I'm thinking. I don't know. It's probably a stupid strategy. but I don't know. I kind of want to try it. I want to have some fun with this. So, we have seen new additions because Lydia was not happy with me having just one creature left to unlock. So, we have the leaked, or was leaked at one point, the Acrocanthosaurus. Has a hybrid, Acrocanthops, which I think is that other dinosaur that's only an event, or it was only in some sort of incubator that you had to buy. We also have this lovely looking thing, the Andrewsarchus, the wolf looking thing that is more closely related to whales, which is kind of terrifying. So there's Andrewsarchus. It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous, really. This new thing, the Troodon, which I thought was going to give Raptor a run for its money. But, get it, a run for its money. But they deliberately placed it one speed less than a Raptor. I mean, you don't see Raptor in competitive play anyway. But this does mean that it could be an interesting, for raid battles or, you know, the events and stuff like that. Not raid, but you know what I mean. And this thing, this new hybrid, the Velostrakos. So if you want another thing, I think, that can just go for an instant charge and do a lot of damage. I mean, it's Velo, so it's already 130 speed. Oh, that's crazy. Like, what is it made out of? Oh, it is. It's made out of, is that Delta? Or is it Charlie? I can never tell. It's Delta. Interesting. So what attacks does it have? High Pounce. Okay, that's good. Cautious Strike. But the Rampage. Ooh, I wonder if you got this thing really high level, what it would be like in competitive. Because at level 130 speed, you don't need an instant. You don't need that instant Rampage. You've got it with High Pounce. Plus, because of the speed, plus it reduces the attack for 50%. Or you can just go for Rampage. None of these attacks you have to wait for. However, you have to have a load of coin in order to do that. So we also have these new hybrids that have come. The Arcanthops, which is the Acrocanthosaurus, and the what's it called? Entrechops? Arctops. Nice name, Arctops. This thing, which is the deer and the sloth, which is interesting. Be weird to see what kind of attacks that thing has. And the new unique, which I'm wondering, and I think I've seen people put this in or some like comment it somewhere, that this is basically what Ardennis Maxima was, meaning that it's god armor and it's good. Not that Ardennis Maxima isn't good, you just need to put boosts on it to make it good. Which already, if you have to put boosts on something to make it good, it's like, is it really good? level 20 for that. Like, if anybody's got this level 30 already, damn. I don't know how you've done that. I would say you've hacked. Just because, you know, this Scunosaurus, whatever it is, the sauropod, has basically been out 2 seconds. So I doubt that you would have enough DNA to do that. And of course, we have Hadrosaur Lux right there. And that, also, yes, emotes are a new thing. So there is so many. And then I think you can switch out emotes. So this Halloween pumpkin one that I don't have, I think was a buy only. So you had to buy the, You had to buy the incubator in order to unlock that emote, which I guess you could say, I want to, you know, you want to collect them all, but really it doesn't make a difference. I guess if they want to have, you know, paid for exclusive emotes, fair enough. It doesn't affect the game. Whereas, you know, when you're putting in boosts to buy, that does affect the game. But if it's emotes, I can kind of, I feel like they were just going to make an emote incubator. Imagine, it's just like, every emote, 100 quid. Bam. I could so see Lunia doing that. How could we make the most amount of money? How about all these exclusive or one super rare emote? And they'll put like, it's only going to be available this one time. We'll never repeat this. Will you buy it? If it was a low amount of money, I think I might. If they say like, we're never going to reproduce this emote, it's just for this second, like, you know, for a week or whatever, I might buy that. But if it's something like 70 quid or 50 quid, I'm not. I can't. Why would you? okay, so that said, I do want to go up. I want to go up. I'm tempted for like maxing Draco. I really am, just because, I mean, it has a hybrid, but what's the point in its hybrid when it's pretty much the same? I mean, yeah, it like has more attack and maybe it's a little bit faster, but Draco Rex's whole gimmick is that it switches in and does like the rendering and that's it. I mean, you can do the cleanse, and I think that's something its hybrid can't do. Oh no, its hybrid can cleanse. It's basically Cunning Strike and Cunning Impact. And you have Fierce Strike and Fierce Impact. So it goes through shield and armor. It's better. Draco Rex is better. Like, why? I mean, 115 speed. Okay, what does it have? 117 speed. So it's one boost ahead. But if you're gonna boost a Draco Rex, or if you're gonna spend boosts on these creatures, one boost, you're not maxing it. So that one boost isn't gonna make a difference, is it? Unless you are maxing a Draco Rex, in which case, why? I mean, I guess it could work, but surely there's other things to spend. Now, one dinosaur I'm thinking about spending is this guy, because I already have a max. And it, look at that, it's like a faster Tenoto Rex, because it can do, the only thing it can't do, sorry, is, you know, reduce speed, but it will have a guarantee instant charge next turn. So, I think this could be good. I think this guy could be good, but what I am going to commit to is me more on Rex. I think I'm going to commit to it. So I can do 5 boosts of health. So already one boost gives us 112 extra health. So we can do 5 at the moment. The max we can do is 10. So we can get, okay, let's think about this. We can give ourselves 25% extra health at 4,525. So 450, 800, and then 5%. So you're looking about 1,000 extra health at level 26. So it'd be like 5,000, right? 5,000 health. You're basically getting 100 each time, I think. Well, that'd be way more then. What are you talking about, James? I'm tempted though, because Mormrex, it doesn't really outspeed much anyway in general. But facing up against a Thordor or a whatchamacallit, the Ankylosaur T-Rex might make a difference. Let's have a look. 108. So already at 1. I might be tempted to throw on maybe 2 more speed boosts just in case. Because I think I've seen a lot of Thordors. A lot of Thordors. And most of them have like 111 speed. So if if somebody's going to commit to outspeed, like putting loads of speed boosts on a Thordor, I don't think there's anything wrong with me putting on, I think one more. I'll put on one more. Taking it to 112. I feel like I've seen Thordor at 111. So just having that one extra might make the difference. And in which case, you know, we're going to do one hit for 4,500 with a good crit chance. I mean, look at my Thordor. It's already maxed, you know, so it has 5,400. At the moment, I don't think I'd be able to kill it in one hit. But level 30 Mormrex would. So having that with a little bit more speed boost might make a difference. Oh, I said I was going to do the health, but maybe speed's the way. I don't know. Anyway, guys, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thanks for watching. We did a Morton v. Mortem a little bit, but really, we needed the Dino Charis at the end to do a heal to really save. Otherwise, I think, you know, Morton Rex could have done a lot of damage to the my Morton Rex, to the enemy Morton Rex, but a lot of dinos would have died. And, you know, those crits would have went through, so. Either way, hope you're enjoying Jurassic World Alive. I'm just going to quickly open up these, see if we get anything good. We probably won't, but hey, we get coin and boosts. Anything? Ooh. Also, they've increased this. It's now 22. It used to be like 10 or something, but doubling it has made so much of a difference. Now when you see a legendary or an epic, whatever it's called, you're like, oh, nice. And we'll open this because I'm sure it'll be a mission. Anything good? Oh, that's important. Yes, you get a whole 4 of those each. And 3, and what do we get out of this? Another 22 of that. Well, guys, if you enjoyed this video, leave a like. And until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.